Everybody, it's Invicta, and as you can tell by the thumbnail, if this did go up on YouTube, we're doing something that I came up with, and it probably is a horrible idea, or maybe it's a great idea. So this is what I call the R-Key Challenge, and thanks to Da Rules Mod by JSG, and also Hutz for telling me like how to actually install it and everything and use it, we are going to be doing something that is going to be kind of different here on the channel and insane. This is going to be standalone, of course, from the Eden Streak and our usual Isaac run-of-the-mill stuff, but I wanted to just do something interesting, and I've been kind of brainstorming ideas of all the crazy stuff I can think of to come up in Isaac with like crazy challenges and maybe even like streak goals. And this one in particular was one that I had last night, and I've never actually tried it. I only just got it working. I should also mention that this was lifted directly from my Twitch stream, so I will be talking to chat every now and then and calling out subs and stuff, but you won't see any of the overlay. I just wanted to put this down if this did go up on YouTube, because that means that something incredible happened, or it was a lot of fun. So essentially what happens is we're gonna be starting off as Isaac just to see how hard this challenge actually is. And the idea of this that I had was that every time you get hit, the R key is going to trigger. So every time that the player takes damage of any kind, it's going to restart the run. But the idea behind it is that you get to keep everything that you accumulated from the previous run. So the hypothetical reason for this run or this challenging existing is because A, it's going to help you get better and learn how to dodge appropriately, because Lord knows you don't want to restart a run when you get all the way to the end. And B, how many times will it take you to actually get a hitless run, a true hitless run? Because literally any damage that you take is going to restart the run. So what I mean by that is any damage is going to restart the run. So this might be a super long video. This might be a super short video. I don't know. We might be able to get a really powerful run early on, and then like let's see how far we can go without taking damage. But again, hypothetically, you should get to a point where you get so many good items, or so many items in general, because you're always accumulating, that you are potentially going to be able to go through a hitless run without ever taking damage ever. I mean, that's literally the only way to end this run. So hopefully this goes well. There may be some balancing and tweaking that I'm gonna have to do and all that kind of good stuff, but for the most part, I think that I would much rather be pretty good. I would much rather just see how far we can get. I do think that my own personal Isaac skill has been, I've been playing decently lately, but definitely not the sharpest. And I think that this is an excellent way to kind of beat it into your skull, into your noggin, that you get a hitless run. You literally have to get a hitless run. Any damage at all is going to restart the run. So this may be a lot of fun. This may be not a lot of fun. I don't know. But as you can see here, you don't get your health back if you lose health. And actually, I probably should have restarted, because this is starting me with like less than 3 HP. But yeah. So you get the idea. How long will it take us to get to a super powerful, overpowered state? I have no idea. But if this ends up catching on, then, you know, if you want to see this more kind of stuff like this, then let me know in the comments down below, and also clicking the like button. Again, I will be talking to my Twitch chat for the time being anyway, because this is just an experimental run. I just wanted to see how long, how it would go. And if it ended up turning out to be hilarious, or, you know, hard or difficult or whatever, but a cool challenge, then, you know, I think that's worthy of putting it here on YouTube. Who knows? May start a new trend. So again, thank you to JSG for he's the mod creator, as well as Hutz for telling me about the mod. And also, of course, I've been using it on Thusmas, and the ideas that I'm coming up with are potentially limitless with how all kind of weird and wacky challenges that you can do. Of course, Hutz has his own challenges that he does with every item is, which you can find over at Hutz's channel, twitch.tv/HutzGaming, and also youtube.com/Hutz, the other half of Thusmas. So how far can we go without taking damage? Well, so far I think we've cleared three rooms, I think, technically. But the principal idea is that you can get through at least to the first floor and start accumulating good items. I brought the D6 along because I think it's going to help us out in the long run, just get more and more powerful. But at the same time, I don't know if you really want to take any angel deals or devil deals or not. Thank you, Morgan, for gifting out a tier 1 sub. So See if we can catch Steven and little Steven here at the same time. There we go. All right, so I don't really want little Steven. I'm going to try to get a reroll to maybe get a different item there, or at least a chance to reroll stuff. I could go take the Unicorn Stump. If we had an Orbital, I actually would consider taking it. Unicorn Stump Orbital was a pretty good starting combo there, but let's see. Let's see what little Steven rerolls into here. Mobbles. I guess if we're going to be taking damage, the thing is that I don't know if it's going to actually, is it actually going to work, or is it going to, I wonder if the gulp effect will go off if we take damage. I guess this is just going to be one of the many different things that we will find out eventually. Actually, Unicorn Stump's gone. That was in the other run. I just remember that we took damage in the fly room, and we don't get Unicorn Stump anymore. By the way, the time will be cumulative. So the R key, to my knowledge anyway, the R key does not reset the timer. So we will have a true real-time count of how long these runs will take. And that's just another kind of like a cool perk of this challenge idea. And again, it might be a little bit lame. It might be kind of laborious, but I think the idea of you being punished for taking damage and thereby, in a way, teaching yourself, hey, don't take damage, this could be a very interesting and powerful maybe training or teaching tool for those of you who are still kind of up and coming in the Isaac world, learning your way. Reclaimzy, thank you very much for the tier 1 sub, resub. So this might end up being like one of the like longest videos ever. I mean, I don't know. It's hard to beat the first one, the Ultimate Isaac run video. That one was almost 3 hours long. And of course the Omega run. Okay, that's cool. All right. That's pretty neat. The Omega run, of course, that one ran 2.5 hours long. This one might be longer, or this might never go up on YouTube ever. Ever. We'll see. Yeah, as you see there at the top, the timer does not reset. So, again, I like the idea. The premise of the idea of this idea is that, you know, just don't get hit. Literally don't get hit. You have to not get hit if you want to win this run. And there is sort of like a weird little bit of punishment factor there as well, is because you don't get the HP back. So, you know, you can't just keep infinitely resetting and resetting. You have to actually find life and get HP upgrades and that sort of thing. But again, you know, how many runs or how many resets will it take before you actually get to a point where you are invincible almost? You can actually walk into a room and then everything just dies. You may notice that we're also not restarting with any of our starting items here for Isaac. We don't get our bombs back, and the D6 does not recharge as well. So, you know, the possibilities are endless. Chat's asking, is breakfasting a possibility? No, it's not, because it resets the run. The loot table is reset when the R key is proc'd. So, yeah, this is going to be interesting. Nighttime Tommy, thank you very much for the 17-month resub here on Twitch. It's either going to be good or bad. To me, like on paper in my brain that I was writing this on paper, this seemed like a fun idea. And also, you know, I think that no matter what level you are, play level you're at, you can certainly always get better. And I'm certainly by no means or stretch of the imagination the best Isaac player in the world. I leave that to other capable Isaac players out there. But if you can get better, then you should. And that's how I kind of look at it. All right, so we picked up the swarm, which is going to give us this some kind of protection against projectiles, and going to be going up against Larry. I wish we had our bombs back, I'm going to be honest. Thank you, Reiner 51, for gifting a tier 1 sub. Paying it forward from Rick Brew. And really, it's going to come down to, I think the most important thing is getting to the second floor and getting to the Devil Deal. The Devil Deal priority resets as well, I believe, anyway, when you R-key, because everything, like, literally everything resets. But you get to keep your items, and that's a pretty cool idea. So hopefully we get some movement speed here. We don't have enough for a reroll, so we kind of we gotta take what we can get from Larry. Yeah, consolation prize gives us range. Hooray! We should go get that soul heart, I think. And we can actually get a lot of money here, actually. Ooh, oh yeah, I forgot. We had the holy penny. We might be able to get a full charge, but meh. Okay, so the goal, this challenge may also force you to create smaller goals for yourself, which is something that I always tell Isaac players to do. Maybe our first initial goal should be getting to the devil deal, the first devil deal, without getting hit. That way we can actually get our devil deal item, and then start progressing further and further. In a weird way, in kind of like a roundabout way, this challenge also kind of plays out like a deck builder, in a sense, because you have to just keep on going, and it turns Isaac into a true roguelite. Which, of course, I mean, it's debatable at this point with repentance, but this way, it's like, yeah, you get hit, you're dead. It's one hit, one death. That's it. So it's like every item that we get is like, ooh, this is going to be good. Ooh, this is going to be even better. Oh, we got something real, real good, you know. Team sale is pretty good. It's pretty good to get. Well, at least we don't have to worry about our early game shops being too expensive. Still gonna be expensive, of course, but not as much as a full charge of 15 cents for premium items. And stuff like Champion's Belt, Black Candle, that sort of thing would be nice. All right, HP's looking good, but this is the room that I've been dreading to going into. And, not a good room. You see the distance that spider traveled just to get to us? I'm gonna have to take down this nub over here. I know there's another one over there. Can't fool me, game. Taking down the mulligan first will be key. It's going to spawn a fat spider, of course. All right, next priority, taking down the nub. All right, we got the high ground. Got it. Okay, we got a full charge. We got out of the room. All we gotta do is find the item room now. And we should be home free. Well, until we get to the boss room. Swarm only activates when being hit by a projectile. Doesn't act like an orbital or anything. And the kicker too is me not getting rid of, I can't pick up another spacebar item because the D6 may not be worth it on one run, but if we get hit, then I'm gonna need my D6 back, and then it ain't gonna be back. No. Sure, we'll take Halo of Flies. Again, a defensive upgrade for us is kind of nice. Hey, we got one of them. Nice, nice. Oh, I thought that just gave us nothing. Yeah, let's go fight the boss. Hopefully we get a good devil deal here. It's gonna be old Dookie. Old Dookie. More like Old Daddy. Oh boy, Pageant Boy. Yay. It's so good. Pageant Boy. Let's see. I'm not really feeling either one of these, to be honest. We can take, we absolutely cannot take Sanguine Bond, but I will take Money Equals Power. And I guess that goes hand in hand with us getting Pageant Boy now, even though we only got like 7 cents out of here. Okay, so we got somewhere. Was that golden chest accessible? I mean, hey, starting a run with Halo Flies, and now we have Money Equals Power is surely going to help us get along with our progression. Secret room might be here. It wasn't. Ooh, girl, there we go. All right, now. 4.78 damage. All right, we could be on to something here. The premise of the challenge is just seeing how far you have to go before you can get a hitless run. In theory, there should be an event horizon of sorts to get to the point where it's like we cannot lose at this point. There's no way that the game can hit us because we're just simply killing everything so fast. Or is it even possible? I mean, there have been times where I've had a super powerful run and then have been hit by like a white fly or something that I just didn't even see. So it's still very possible for you to take damage in those runs. It's just it's highly unlikely that the game is going to be able to do much against that. I think we should take the counterfeit penny over the blessed penny for now. Probably should have used the bombs instead of the keys there. Rotten Heart, Soul Heart, it's pretty good. Spiders in this room are the most important thing to take out. We are virtually untouchable with this many flies right now with the swarm. And if it somehow does make it through the swarm, then it still has to go through a halo of flies, which, good luck for that. Pandora's box, we get one boss item. I think that's probably worth taking and using, but I don't want to buy it until we have another item that we can reroll with the D6. So we can create ourselves a second item pedestal. There we go. Okay. Even if we were ready to fight the boss, which we aren't, I wouldn't go in there without having a full charge for the possible deal with the devil. And if we're going to use or buy Pandora's box, then we need to make it to where we wouldn't be able to use both at the same time. Hey. That was a 6 cent nickel. Right, so damage is starting to get a little above average for where we usually are. Can actually get this nickel and cardio coin, maybe. Yeah, we can't get the nickel. I could have been doing this with the blessed penny, but I think that with the counterfeit penny, the amount of money that we can get from cardio coin alone should be more value than what we would get if we were just getting like half soul hearts here and there. And now we're sitting at 6.32 damage, which is real good. Full card, okay. Fortune cookie. But I think what we want to do is let's go fight the boss and see if we get our devil deal. If we don't get our devil deal, then we'll buy Pandora's box, go into the item room, and then re-roll with D6, unless Pandora's box gives us something amazing. So far, we've gotten through 3 floors with this current setup without getting hit. And it's taken us 16 minutes and 21 seconds to get here. Now, I thought about doing this on an Eden start as well. And again, I may be incorporating this into a future Light Streak goal. But I just wanted to introduce the idea of the R Key Challenge and just see how it goes, you know? I'm not only the creator of the challenge, but I'm also a member or something. I don't know. I'm not fearful of Gertie Jr. or Gertie, for that matter. It's the flies and the nubs that are the problem. There we go. Good. I am going to take Cat of Nine Tails. I don't think that perfection is going to matter because obviously if we take damage, not only will that just simply disappear, but also the run will be restarted and then we will have no trinket. And I think Counterfeit Penny with Money Equals Power is going to be pretty darn good. So we're going to have to go all the way back. Not hitting the Temperance Machine, because that would be a terrible idea. All right, so we have two item pedestals to reroll through. Taking damage now would be what I would call suboptimal, because we would lose the D6. What is in here? Kind of looking for a full charge, or two, or ten. Hangman might be pretty pogged. Just imagine if we get something like, I don't know, Echo Chamber or, if we get Brimstone, starting a run with Brimstone Money Equals Power, that's got to be a real strong start. We'll take Papula Duplex. We will not be taking Fruitcake. I think we'll head on to Zaun. I will go use the Hangman card to get, we could get that Soul Heart. I think it's actually better for me to get this 6, possibly 7 cents over here for the damage. My fool card. Okay, so far, so good. We're cruising along, even though we don't have an incredible build right now. We're still moving the yardstick. Fruitcake is absolutely not something that I want to be taking on an R Key challenge. The second that you take damage from any source, you get rerolled, or you don't get rerolled, but the run starts completely over again. No, thank you. I think I will respectfully and regrettably have to say no to such a request. Red Candle's stock for me has gone way down. The fact that fire doesn't always burn things. Ace of Hearts could be kind of good. We need to at least clear this big room over here if it has a bunch of stuff we don't want to. Yeah, has a bunch of stuff that we don't care about or want to be around. Then yeah, we'll go ahead and just use it as a room clear. I think that we could go fairly far in this run with this defensive setup that we've got currently. It's a pretty neat idea because, again, it kind of turns Isaac into a little bit of a deck builder. It feels a little bit Slay the Spire-ish. We're picking and choosing, like, components, and then it's like, oh, darn, we got to restart. Like, you know, it's a new day or something like that. And let's just smash the game right in the face whenever we get strong enough. Let's see, Trolls. We didn't have a full charge in the shop. One thing I don't like is that we're only getting one. We're basically only getting one reroll per floor right now. That could be interesting if we took Samson's Chain and turned it into Echo Chamber with a D6, that could be potentially game ending. Bone Heart. Thank goodness for the swarm. Thank you, Sarcastic Meanie, for the Twitch resub of 7 months. Okay, let's see if we can get past Rag Mega. Now, the swarm is not going to protect us from the Dark Matter Balls or from the purple beam attack that Rag Mega has, so we got to be careful here. Yeah, we did get a deal with the devil. I will take an HP upgrade. Oh man, Twisted Pear and Guppy's Head. And we can reroll Guppy's Head into... Yep. Okay. All right. Twisted Pear is going to help us out quite a bit. And this has easily been the furthest run that we've gotten so far anyway. Now, inevitably, someone's going to say, what about Alt Path Week? No, I'm not going Alt Path right now. Alt Path is the last thing on my mind right now. I think we have nothing. No, we have a Bone Heart. I take that back. We could bomb for more damage. Yeah, I think we just head on down. We have a much higher chance of winning a run without getting hit if we don't go alt path. This is potentially for YouTube, but I'm treating it as if it's not going on there, maybe. All right, we made it to depths one so far without taking any damage. With this build. So as long as we're moving the needle, you know, progressively, I think that's the best way to be. Yeah, Tinted Rock here. Definitely could use some damage. That would be damage. Although it does destroy our movement speed quite a bit, but Twisted Pear is also gonna be dealing more damage now. I'm gonna turn down a tears upgrade if we get one. We might be doing this with an Eden run. I think that would be a fun like streak challenge. I think that this potentially is a really good teaching tool for Isaac players of every experience level. It's going to force you to say, yeah, I've got a hitless run. I mean, the run had to restart like 400 times, but I eventually got to the point where I went through an entire run without ever taking damage. How cool is that? You know, now obviously it's not a true hitless run because you're starting with a huge advantage of just keeping every item that you had from the previous run. But nonetheless, it's still very difficult to go through an entire run in Isaac without ever taking damage, no matter how strong you are. Up to a point. The critical mass, that's where I'm wondering, you know, where is this critical mass going to be at? You know, is it going to be in our damage? Is it going to be in our just ability or like tier effects? Or, you know, if we find a good space where I'm like mega, is that enough to take you through an entire run starting from zero to get a hitless victory on Blue Baby or whoever you dictate as the final boss? For this challenge, I am going to be talking about Blue Baby because it's a standard run. I feel like the item room is over here. Certainly Twisted Pear is doing work, but Money Equals Power has been our biggest acquisition so far. And that was due only to the D-Sizzle, so thank you to D-Sizzle. Holy Mantle, of course, would be awesome, because then we wouldn't have to worry about taking one hit. But we don't have Holy Mantle, and I definitely do not want to drop my movement speed down any further than it is. Ooh, member card could be pretty pogged. Member card could be a GG. Especially with us starting with Steam Sale as well. Mr. Dolly. Soul of Apollyon. I'm going to take Mr. Dolly. Obviously, we need the tears up. Soul of Apollyon. We get the locusts. Just have flies everywhere. I don't think so. Now, Alabaster Box is interesting, but we've taken a Devil Deal, and I don't think that it is going to help us on this run. Look at all these freaking flies, man. So once again, we're only going to get one reroll here on the floor. Well, start off with anyway, but we do have a full charge in the store. That's pretty good. Twisted Pear with Mom's Knife. I mean, is this enough? Is this gonna be it? I don't know, man. Glass Cannon on this build is interesting. It would give us a lot more damage to deal. I don't think it makes a big knife. I'm going to take it. I'm going to take Glass Cannon. We should reroll the store, though. I don't think it's going to shoot a big knife, no. I think Glass Cannon may actually be pretty good. Okay. Who would have ever thought that we would have taken Glass Cannon? Now, the kicker here is that we're permanently giving up the D6, so... We gotta see if this is the call or not. I don't know. Thank you, D-Sizzle. it didn't shoot a big knife, but it did shoot a big tear. Oh my gosh. Uh-oh. Okay. The needles can still hit us. I'm gonna take it in case we do get hit. We're gonna need the red hearts to get our new devil deal. feel like I don't want to be in mom hen rooms. I feel like that's the best way for us to get hit. Flying would also be greatly appreciated. You know what? We're gonna have to go through the spike room, aren't we? Nope, you both gotta go. I don't go unless you both go. Our movement speed is not fast enough for this. Woo! Yeah. Trinket Smelter is pretty good here. I will take Sackhead as well. Okay, all right now. Void, I think Callus is good for the Trinket Smelter. Not to worry about walking over spikes that I don't see, which would totally not be my fault. It'd be the game's fault, of course, not mine. None. Never. That is not a double-tended rock, even though it looks like one. All right, we made it to mom. Need to be careful with the knockback of glass cannon. Woo! Down goes mama. Satanic Bible. Satanic Bible would give us devil deals at the end of the boss, but we already have mom's knife, though, is the thing. I'm gonna stick with glass cannon. I like this idea that we've got here. Okay, I think we're making good progress. 31 minutes. We made it past mom. Yeah, I mean, I've never made a single mistake. It's the game's fault, not mine. Clearly. I only wish we had shielded tears for a glass cannon. Emperor is pretty good if we can get to the chest. Stay back. Stay back. Okay, Eternal Heart will take. Yeah, Swarm is saving us a lot of heartache here. Brett. Psyfly! Oh my Gertie. And we just got flying as well from Beelzebub. That was definitely worth the side trip. The only thing I'm worried about is our movement speed, or our lack of movement speed. Uh-oh. Whew. My God. They have a Psyfly. Our only hope. All right, we're still doing it. We're still okay. Oh man, glass cannon is just shredding. Look at that. Look at that shot by Lead Pencil. All right. Golex ain't bad. Woo. Another HP upgrade. Terrific. Death's List. Well then. I will be taking that, and I guess we could take brimstone bombs too. Sure. Get 5 more bombs, brimstone, we'll take it. All right. Scarred Womb. Hey, hopefully we'll get some movement speed upgrades. A death list. Okay. Every money, every piece of currency that we get more and more damage. And that's going to scale very well with Mom's knife. Secret room is below here. I don't actually think we need to go in there, though. Yeah, well, there's a curse room here. Not take that back. No, I knew that the pushback from Glass Cannon was probably going to be the problem there. I knew that the knockback from Glass Cannon was going to be an issue. I think we, oh no, wait, we smelted Counterfeit Penny too. That's the only worry that I had, was that with his movement speed, that the knockback from Glass Cannon was going to be a problem. All right, we got tech 0.5. We probably don't want shot speed up as Mom's knife, but hey, we made it to Scarred Womb 2 with this build, which is still pretty good. We should have gone further though, I feel. But we got Mom's knife now, so we should be able to go for Angel Deals and make the difference up. Ooh. Silver Dollar might be pretty good. Perthrow is good, but it's not Emperor card good. There's the blind. Well, we were gonna be skipping the Devil Deal anyway, so I think we have the Devil Deal item that we need, so I don't think we need anything else. Full of Azazel. Heartbreaking. Hierophant card. Come on, give us a movement speed upgrade. That was a shot speed upgrade. We don't need a shot speed upgrade game. And look at all those extra blue flies we got from Beelzebub. Look at that. Look at that. Hey, a damage up. It's not a movement speed upgrade, and that's okay. And we probably have a decently sized planetarium chance. I fly going ham right now. Yeah, bursting sacks, not bad. Luck upgrade. Champion belt. Okay, all right now. All right now. Damage is starting to get fiercer and fiercer. I apologize for not giving the seed every time that, like, the run resets. I'm pretty sure the seed stays the same. One Juliet, Golf Juliet, Kilo, Quebec, Yankee 8. If we get a hit again, which is a very real possibility, then I will check the seed and hopefully I remember what it was and what it used to be. Tech point 5 is going to be pretty massive here. Still want movement speed, though. There we go. Very nice. Did get an angel deal. Old bandage. And we got to go for the holy knife. The holy knife is just so good. And imagine if it procs off of glass cannon. That's massive. Which run number is this? Is this run number 4 now, Moshpit? Those of you who are watching this on Twitch live. Is this run 4 or run 3? Not including the runs that we did to, like, show what the mod did. They're thinking run 4. Got a planetarium. Planetarium. I'm worried about these friendly bomb flies. Hope they got destroyed. They didn't. I mean, pretty good. Did you see the size of that icicle? Okay, I think we lost some of the explodey flies. Throw. All we have to do is just get to the chest. And thank God the fires killed most of the flies. That is the biggest Uranus I've ever seen. What are you looking at? I like this white beam that we're shooting out with Tech Point 5. Second steam sail would have been kind of nice. Nun's Habit. could be useful. Oh my god. Apparently, Holy Light can proc off of Tech Point 5, we just learned. That's also pretty incredible. Dang it, I was trying to destroy the fly. Apparently Tech Point 5 can trigger Holy Light. Oh jeez. Got another HP upgrade, which is just getting insulting at this point. I want my movement speed. All right, 43 minutes and we're back here on Necropolis 1. My god, the glass cannon icicle tier just freezes everything as soon as it touches it. Ooh. Keeper's Bargain is kinda pogged. Yeah, when Larry Jr. can catch up to you when he's just like scooting around on the floor, that's bad. Oh my goodness. I mean, it's going to hurt our damage a lot, but now we just have that many more knives. If I could just get a little movement speed. Keeper sack, come on now. Thank you. That's all I want. I just want a little bit of movement speed. That's all I'm asking for. We don't have to be moving at 2.0 movement speed, but you know, something better than like a 0.80 would be fantastic. I already showed you the seed. The seed stayed the same as I predicted. Got a luck upgrade. Woo! Range upgrade. Okay. Seed is different. One Juliet, Golf Juliet, Kilo, Quebec, Yankee 8. Pretty sure that's the same seed. Nice. Holy Mantle would make it to where Holy Mantle would I'm pretty sure it would not trigger the R key effect. Because I'm pretty sure that the rule that I have in place states on damage. Finally. Alright, we're almost in 1.0 movement speed range. Almost there. Good. DH Dizzle. We could take coupon. Hey. No, we don't want to do that. We got moving speed. My gosh, we almost have decent mobility. Woo! Oh no. Okay, fires, please help us out. Thank you. Hello, DHN dealer. And hello to Dubai. That is a city that I wish to visit, but probably never will in my life. Not out of choice, just like I don't think I'll ever have the opportunity to go to Dubai. I'd love to go there though. It's like a bucket list. Oh yeah, we have PhD. The goal has to be destroying the bomb flies before they get a chance to explode immediately as soon as I go into a new room. Hopefully it destroys itself on its boss. Okay, we got ourselves an angel deal. Unfortunately, we can't see what it is. Oh, good. Just what we wanted. Literally could not have been a worse item. Heaven Seals is good now. No, it's not. It is not. They made it better. No, it didn't. It can still damage you. That's the biggest problem with it. Tizzle. Huh. That's going to be interesting. With Uranus and Holy Light, Tech 2 could be kind of pog. Or kind of not. Hey, we got movement speed. Oh, Vivi's here. Run's over. The run is over. Rip. It was a good run, everyone. I wonder if we should take the Bible instead of Glass Cannon. Just so we have a free mom kill and mom heart kill. DHN dealer, thank you very much for the tier one sub as well. Here on Twitch, welcome to the Mosh Pit. That's pretty good. Squeezy. All right, we're at an hour now. 50 minutes on the game timer total. We can still turn this into a respectable time. I mean, hell, we've had runs that have gone way longer than that. So we're still in respectable time limits for now. And Tech 2 and Uranus are just they're just like two peas in a pod. Don't look at me like that. Oh boy. All right. Spider mod. I mind. Boga bombs. Yeah. Now we're getting somewhere. Don't even give her a chance. Think negative. We already have the Polaroid. Sensor. Very nice. Very nice. We're good. Gucci. Okay. And curse the loss. Another range upgrade, okay. Uh oh. We're okay, we're still okay. We're just going in the wrong directions. Yeah, Hive Mind Swarm is a big help. Sci-Fly said no. Sci-Fly shutting this down. All right, good. Another dead end here. Good. Good. Hustle. All right. All right. Well, we lost our Emperor card now. Sure. We could still make this a respectable run. CEO Maker FX, thank you very much for the 300 bits. All right, we'll get back there quick. We'll get back there quick. I ain't even worried about it. Planetarium, okay. Soul, sure. This is where the boss is anyway. Dragon Jays, thank you very much for gifting out 5 tier 1 Twitch subs here in the mosh pit. The faster we get to the boss, the faster that we can get a payout from Lost Soul. Right? 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 Salvation's probably not going to do much for us, but, you know, it might. Sure. Thank you, Dragon Jays. Last soul paint out with soul hearts. The D fizzle. No, thank you. I would undo an hour's worth of work. And bad damage. Hey, thank you, Dragon. sure that turned out to be a dead end, but I'm certainly not going to listen to Vivi. She's the mistress of bad luck. Rat Crown used to be pogged. Not quite pogged anymore. Evie claims that she would never steer me wrong. Damage is looking pretty nice. Thank you, Sun. Thank you, Soul, for activating three times for some reason. Why did Soul go off three times there? Eternal Hearts, neat. I mean, Smartfly is not going to do much, but you know, it's good. Good to see you. Went off for one of each part of Chubb. Seems legit. So max our movement speed. Ooh. Book of Virtues with the Bibble. How's that gonna work? Loving our spectral tears. Look upgrade, okay. Man, Tech 2 and Holy Light are just scary. Okay, Jar of Wisps. I think I'll pass on that. All right, the furthest we've been able to get is Womb 2. It's the furthest that this run has gotten so far. The amount of flies that we have is making this difficult to see where the shadows are. Somehow we got a Deathless Pay out of that room. Don't ask me how I did that. Awesome, I am so done with you. Glad you enjoy heavy metal. We can do it. Keep the momentum. We got to keep the momentum going now. Didn't take us that long to get back here. Got speed. Eh. Flying is definitely a big help. Now that was just a cool, satisfying room, you gotta admit. Hey, down goes Mom's heart. Okay. Delic Prism is not Godhead, by the way. So on run number, what, 6? 1 hour and 10 minutes later, of course we get Curse of Lost. And 59 minutes game time. We're finally at the cathedral. That's real good. A library. All the stuff, all the visual doo-doo that's going on the screen right now is also making it kind of difficult to see what's going on. Really wish we had that Emperor card. No! I didn't even see the blue fire, man. I didn't even see that blue fire because of everything that's surrounding us. Hate it. The empty vessel was completely useless here, but we'll take it. Oh, we got another XL4. I didn't even realize that. Okay. Oh, Lost Soul's still alive. Planetarium. The only damage we've been taking outside of the mom hands has been from environmental objects. And that one, we ran into a blue fire that I didn't see till the last second. I was going to go up to line up the shot on the deacon and the explodey flies. But I didn't see the blue fire up there. I need to be cautious about flying through every single room just willy-nilly, because again, one white fly, one spike rock, anything like that, and it's, you know, you're over. Gotta start all over again. Not one guardian angel. Ooh, I don't know about this one. Okay. That's certainly something. Gonna make things very difficult to see Immaculate Heart. Well, damage is not a problem. Should we try to go for Dogma? Just full send it. Maybe Dogma is the right way. Maybe this is the way of our people. Going on in here. Fire deck. He forgot. Thank you for the tier one sub. Yes, finally, treasure map. Moon car gets us into the ultra secret room. Sacred Heart. Oh my Gertie. All right, we got ourselves an urn. We've got enough damage.
Spent it. It's gone.
What's our time at? 104. We can still make this into a respectable run. I'm just going to keep saying it until I will it into existence. Golden Troll Bomb. Now there is a way to lose the run. Rotten Baby, sure. Aquarius, sure. All right. We're just gonna have to no hit Dogma and Beast. Yeah, I mean, how hard is that? That can't be that hard, right? I've done it before. Done before, even when I wasn't trying. So surely that means that now.
Pushing me like this, I'm leaving.
Good, leave. We'll be fine without you. Abandon us like you abandoned yourself.
Yeah, it's just a DPS check. It's a big deal.
You need to repent. You need to confess.
Yeah, Aquarius is real good now. All right, good. Oh yeah, we had Cursed XL, let's try it. How great it would be if Holy Mantle was in here. Oh wow, we got Knowledge's Rune. So the question is, who do we use the Outage Rune on? Dogma or Beast? Here we go. I think we're going to use it for Beast. All right. Can we beat Beast in less time it takes for the Algis rune to go off? Let's find out. Mammon down. Eslin's down. War down. Death down. I think we have to use the Odger's rune now. Because I don't want to get hit by a spike from behind. Odger's rune has been popped. What? He's done it! All right.
Then suddenly, the sky above cracked open, and a white beam of
all right, it only took us 7 runs and 1 hour, 21 minutes, and 55 seconds, but we did it. I'm going to put that on YouTube because it was a lot of fun, even though we had a couple instances of bad damage. I think this is an interesting challenge for everyone to try out for yourself. And again, thank you very much to JSG as well as Huts for introducing me to this mod. JSG, of course, is the maker of this mod. I want to make sure I'm getting that one correct. I'm pretty sure it's JSG. So thank you all very much. I appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more types of these kind of challenges with the rules mod, let me know in the comments down below. And the best way to let me know in doing so is by simply clicking the like button. It only takes less than a second, and it helps out an extremely large amount. Thank you all very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.